Hello, everyone. Thanks for joining me today in a conversation about Azure Government and our Cloud Solution Provider Program, also known as CSP. Today, we will cover a set of resources, an overview of the program, as well as a demo of our portal and capabilities that you can take advantage of. Let's level set and talk a little bit about what Azure Government is. If you're here, that means that you're probably interested in learning about our CSP program as well as Azure Government. But what does Azure Government really mean? To start with, we have Azure, which is a commercial instance, and then we have Azure Government, which is specific for our state, local, and federal agencies. Now, both of these clouds are completely separate. So you need to understand that no data commingles. They are completely secure, protected by different compliance standards. So that's something that really provides an edge when you're dealing with government customers. Now, the CSP program, which is something that we'll cover throughout this overview, is something that is specific to the Azure Government Cloud. Yes, we have a commercial counterpart, but in the Azure Government area, this program is what you're looking for. Let's talk about what CSP enables partners to do. First, you need to be able to create solutions, provide billing, and provide support for your customers. You become the first line of defense, and that's something that's very important. Microsoft is always there to back you up, but as a CSP, you provide the first line of defense for your customer. Now, you can manage your subscriptions for them, add additional things on top. The customer may call you one day and say, hey, I no longer want to do this. So they have the ability to cancel at any time. So you can build an ongoing customer relationship and build services on top. Azure is only one of the products that can be sold through CSP, but there's many more that will be joining our line of products going through this particular channel. Let's go a little bit deeper and understand the customer needs. You may know the traditional way of doing business with Microsoft via an enterprise agreement, but CSP is a new channel in which you can transact. Now, as a customer, you may be looking for an end-to-end relationship and many services. Somebody like a systems integrator can provide that for you. Additionally, as a customer, you don't want to spend time dealing with different contracts, with different products all splattered around the plane. You can use CSP as a single way to transact. Azure is one of the products located there today, but many more are to come. If you're an ISV, CSP is also a very good channel for you. CSP enables you to create single-tenant solutions where all of your data, all of your assets and virtual machines can be segmented at a customer-by-customer basis. This allows you to show in a single pane of glass, all of your billing consolidated, all of your reporting, and you can share that with your customers and have an effective way of managing them. Lastly, partnership is one of the main goals. Here you establish a continual relationship with your customer. It's not a simple transactional operation, but you can really upsell, provide additional services, and go from there. This does not take away from an EA. Keep in mind that if a customer has the capacity to deliver their own IT, or if this is for internal usage, an enterprise agreement is a very good way to go. Additional things to keep in mind is if you're an ISV working with a multi-tenant solution, EA continues to be a very good option for you. What are some of the sweet spots of the CSP program? One thing that you need to understand is each one of these will give you value both as a partner and as a customer. So we talked about strong partnerships. Now, we're going to talk about customers that are in flux. They get different products at different times, have different needs. They need that pay-as-you-go capability. They don't want to be tied to a commitment in a particular time frame. They want to be able to move in and out. Think of your cell phone bill. When you travel, you have one need. When you're local, you have another one. A fully managed set of capabilities where, as a partner, you have that one-stop shop for all your needs and all your customers. And lastly, you have workloads across the enterprise. We're not talking about a particular solution that only focuses on cloud. You're talking about building a long-lasting practice that starts with cloud and goes into delivering a service on top of that. What are your options, though, as becoming a CSP? You have two, to both procure it as well as become one. Let's talk about them. So there is one that is called the direct partner and one which is called an indirect provider. Both of them have benefits and needs that you as a customer or partner may be more inclined to take. Let's begin with the indirect or indirect provider model. There you will see that you have a big CSP, a corporation that is only focused on reselling the infrastructure part of it. If we talk about Azure, you will see somebody only transacting Azure and relying on an indirect reseller to do the rest. If you are a small company or a small entity and you require to have lots of speed, come to market fast, leverage the capabilities for billing and support that a big enterprise has, the indirect path is for you. Yes, there will be a hidden margin because you will have to share that between the provider and the reseller, but all the benefits that that big provider brings are the things that you need to keep in mind. Now, if you're a partner that has a build practice that includes their billing, the support, maybe the direct path is for you. In a direct model, you are responsible for your customer, you are responsible for the end-to-end relationship, and as I said, billing and support are key. Having these two models in place, you have the flexibility to either build a practice or become an indirect reseller, joined by an indirect provider, and move forward and faster to market. This does not exclude you from becoming a direct partner. You can grow, and as your business grows, you can switch and eventually become a direct partner yourself. So we've talked about the in and outs of the program, what it is, who can apply, but let's really see what it takes. To do that, we're going to do an overview of our portal as well as the application process. So let's take a look online and see what resources you have at your disposal to move forward. So what you're seeing right now on your screen is our Azure Government CSP application process. This is a website that we've created for you to walk you through the application process end to end. You will see that you can find all relevant links and all necessary information that you will require to become a government CSP. The way to get to this page is aka.ms/AzureGovCSP. There are several other resources that you can take advantage of. One of them is our Azure Government Application Desk. What this does is allows you to get validated as an Azure Government candidate. What does that mean? So anyone that goes into the Azure Government Cloud needs to be validated as an entity or a partner that has legitimate access to that cloud. What you're seeing right here in the screen is our application form. Every partner, as well as every customer that wants to go into this cloud, would be required to fill out this application form. This ensures that they're vetted and they're a valid government entity or a partner that can enter the program. It's a fairly simple online application. As you can see, it requires some basic information about your organization. Once you have completed the form, you will be able to move forward and receive an email granting you access into the Azure Government Cloud. This gives you an identity and a tenant within the Azure Government Cloud, and from there on, you can move forward and begin the CSP application process. What you're seeing on your screen now is our Partner Center. Partner Center is that single pane of glass that we referred to earlier as the management plane for the CSP partners. If you're a customer, this is not something that you will ever interact with, but your partner will definitely leverage it to manage you. Several partners have also opted to use our APIs and build on top of this. So as a partner, if you want to extend this into your day-to-day business, feel free to do so. We have extensive documentation that you can leverage to do so. Now, going back to our Partner Center, this is our main dashboard. Here you can see your ongoing billing, some quick links and tasks as creating new customers. I will gather that most of you will spend their time in our pricing and offer section, which is located under the sales tab, and our customers tab, which allows you to create the net new customers as well as manage those that are already existing. Focusing on the pricing and offers, you will see an overview of all the different Azure SKUs, as well as our Azure pricing calculator. Now, why these are relevant for you is because every time you need to respond to a customer with a pricing or a proposal, this is where most of your time will be spent. Current price list is located here. This will show you all of the different SKUs as mentioned. The pricing calculator, which is this link, allows you to create estimates that all of your customers can leverage to get an idea of what their environment may cost. Let's go into our billing tab. The billing tab is one area where you can manage your customer spend. You will be able to see on a monthly basis how much every subscription is spending, as well as establish soft limits for them. For example, at an 80%, they can get an email saying you're reaching your established limit of expenditure for this particular month. This is what this overview looks like, as well as our APIs for extensibility. There's some that you can leverage to extend this and get daily readings of the usage. Let's go quickly to our customers tab. As I showed you before, in the customers area, you will see all of your customers and all of the different areas that they have used. Now, if I click on add a customer, this will allow me to create a net new customer. You can notice that from a country perspective, I can only select United States, of course, because this is focused on the US government. I will create a new company for this purpose. I will call it CSP Demo and give it a domain. This domain becomes its little piece of existence within the Azure Government Cloud. This will be a subtenant of your own as a partner. So I've named it CSP Demo 2. Domain is already in use. So when you see this particular message here in red, that means that the domain is not available. Let's go for something more generic as CSP Demo 99. Looks like it's available. So I can easily move forward and then continue with the customer creation. I'll add the address of my customer, and all these fields will be validated. So keep in mind that you cannot enter a random address. Addresses are taken off to a service, and eventually, if you do not have a right one or does not match an existing one, it will potentially give you some grief. And I'll move along to the subscriptions. Here, you will see the Azure Government subscription. Since today, as I said, we have Azure Government on CSP, in the future, we will see the additional subscriptions as well as services that you can select for all your customers. Office will be joining us as well as CRM Online, just as in our commercial counterpart. So keep that in mind as you acquire new customers. Finally, we review the information that we've entered. You will see an overview of everything of the information that you captured. You can go back and update it. When you click Submit, this will commence the tenant creation process. You will see that only in a matter of seconds, a new tenant will be created, and I will be provided with an administrator account that I can give on to my customer, and they can begin spinning workloads in the cloud. So the confirmation page that you see right now is basically that my tenant has been created. Here is my admin account, a temporary password. Make sure to change that when you log in for the first time. And from there on, you can continue to use Azure either as a customer or the CSP portal as a partner to continue to support your customers. You have seen that only in a matter of minutes I've been able to create a customer from zero to a full-blown tenant. Let's take the next step and log in into this customer's tenant and see what that looks like. The first time of login, you will see that you're requested to change this temporary password. So make a note of the new password that you have used. Keep in mind, I am using the customer's account that was just created. As I log in, you will see that they have full access to the Azure portal. They can see their dashboard, they can begin creating virtual machines, and from there on, they're ready to move workloads to the cloud. As you have seen, we've gone over a lot of resources with you today. We've started with how to become a CSP all the way into a quick overview of key features of Partner Center. That's not where it ends. There's a rich set of APIs that you can leverage to extend its functionality. So to do that, we'll share more resources with you. There's a rich set of links that you can leverage. Click on every single one of them, review the information, and make sure to build your practice as a CSP. Again, thank you for joining us, and we'll be looking out for your application for a CSP in government. Thanks.